Wacam has been an environmental human rights organization, and their focus is using knowledge advocacy to get communities to realize self, for them to take the right decisions. So all that we do is to build the capacities of communities that are affected. We engage in research, and then out of the research findings, we formulate a policy brief that we use to engage policymakers on the need to review some of the protocols that we have in mind.
We talk about gender equity and all those things, it's true. But you see, the truth is also that because of the specific roles that have been assigned to, you know, the different genders or the different sexes in our societies, what happens is that when there's an interruption, okay, within the economic and the social structure within the community, it affects the different roles differently. Which then invariably means that it affects the different sexes differently, okay? And an acknowledgement of the fact that it affects us differently is important, okay? So that we can now start paying attention to how it affects us differently, and therefore, how can we then deal with the issues, okay, that emanate from that differences in these kinds of things.
If you go through the policies that have been designed for mining in the country, the policies have been very oblivious of the fact that women face a lot of challenges which is disproportionate than other persons such as men in with the mining communities or anywhere. And so the policies have not been enacted to ensure that this disproportionate impact of mining on women is taken into consideration.
It appears that, but the conscience of our leaders, I don't know, but it seems to have been bought, because if you think about the fellow citizens and fellow Ghanaians who are living in these communities and how passionate they are, people are losing their lives as a result of these things. People's source of income is being cut off. Land where they are supposed to be used for farming, and then you have people or these institutions being given licenses to actually go and mine there, and people's source of livelihood just cut off. They have nothing, nowhere to look up to. And with the advocacy of Wacam, you realize that most of them are now getting to know what their rights are. They were not forthcoming. All they used to do was to demonstrate, and even if you demonstrate, you are being arrested.
There was a need to really pay attention to the critical needs of women who live in the affected communities, more so because of the double, triple effects of mining on their lives. And then also look at the bigger question of mining to communities and how it's affecting their quality of life.
Over the years, mining has gone on in Ghana. A lot of issues have happened, but there have not been an open and the national forum discussion, enough of them to discuss some of these issues. So I think that it's an opportunity for us to share our experiences with those of us working in around the field, and also an opportunity to interact with the people themselves who are right there suffering from all the mining related issues.
One thing that is of interest to me is how underdeveloped these communities are, because we get so much from the gold that they mine, and you go to these communities, say Obuasi, where I happen to use quite a lot, because going to school I used to use the road very well. Even the roads are terrible. There's nothing that shows that Obuasi is a mining community.
Very important, and I'm very hopeful that going forward from now, we will be looking at having a kind of a women-sensitive policies.
Maybe we need to engage government more, especially when it gets to resettlement of some of the community. You can't just take decisions for the entire community when they themselves are not involved.
I simply feel that you know, the agenda should simply be that we should acknowledge, okay, we should acknowledge that different people are affected differently, and therefore, as we move on, you know, the amendment of policies, practices, you know, laws, regulations, etc., we should start paying attention to some of those things.
All the research findings that we are discussing today came from community mobilization, sensitization, and then followed up with empirical assessments to really situate them within the scientific arena. So all that we're going to do is to continue that kind of work.
This particular program is a great one to sensitize people. I believe that the recommendations that are made here will go a long way to actually help most of these people that live in the rural communities, especially the women, because they bear the brunt of all these things that go on.
Once you have majority of the people demanding accountability, demanding that rights are respected in a particular manner, including the rights of women, including the rights of girls, including the rights of youth, including the rights of people who are physically challenged, and everybody who is vulnerable in society. That is when you make headway.